नमस्कार, आई एम डॉक्टर अंशु जिंदल फ्रॉम जिंदल हॉस्पिटल मेरठ। आई एम एन इनफर्टिलिटी एंड IVF स्पेशलिस्ट एंड एन ऑब्स्टेट्रिशियन एज वेल। वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक टुडे, दैट इज पुअर ओवेरियन रिस्पॉन्स इन IVF। वी ऑल नो दैट व्हेन देयर आर लेस दैन 3 ओसाइट्स रिट्रीव्ड इन एन IVF साइकिल, इट इज डिफाइंड एज पुअर ओवेरियन रिस्पॉन्स। एंड the incidence varies from 9% to 26% in all IVF cycles. This varying difference in the incidence is because the definition of defining a poor response is not very clear. But the Bologna criteria in 2011 tried to define the poor response in IVF, and they said that at least 2 out of these 3 features should be met to call it a poor ovarian response. And these included age more than 40 years or any other risk factor for poor ovarian response, or on previous occasion if the patient has not fared well on 2 occasions with less than 3 oocytes in spite of adequate stimulation, or abnormal ovarian reserve test, which includes an AMH value between 0.5 to 1.1 nanograms per ml and an AFC count of between 5 to 7 only from both the ovaries. Dr. Kuldeep Jain is a gold medalist and a university position holder. He's a senior infertility specialist and IVF expert at KJ IVF Center at Delhi. He's a past president of Indian Fertility Society. And I remember when he took over as the president of Indian Fertility Society, he spoke about poor response in his presidential address. He was awarded the fellowship in ART from KK IVF in Singapore. He has been an examiner for various universities with 45 research papers to his credit, editor-in-chief of the Fertility Science and Research Journal, which is also the official journal of IFS, and 300 invited lectures. Such a celebrated doctor, and let's hear from him.
Namaskar, I am Dr. Kuldeep Jain, Director, KJ IVF and Laparoscopy Center, Delhi. Poor response in IVF would be a really frustrating experience in any of the IVF program. It could be a nightmare for clinician as well as patients. So today I am going to share 5 of my secrets of managing poor responder in my practice. My first secret to manage poor responder is I always look for the problem. Before starting, if you assess your patient properly, considering her age, AMH values and enter follicle count, you may manage the patient wisely and in a better way. So always consider all 3 parameters which are highly suggestive of poor response before starting any protocol. That might really help you in deciding the dose as well as in titration during the protocol, and that may give you a better outcome. My second secret is counseling. Counseling is very, very important in these patients. Once you have decided a protocol and expected outcome, you should always counsel your patient regarding the risk of cancellation. Most of these patients, they may land up in cancellation of the cycle. So if you counsel your patient before starting the cycle regarding the risk of cancellation and what you are expecting from your cycle, she may take it in the better spirit. My third secret is choose your protocol wisely. It should always be individualized. Single protocol cannot be applicable for all patients. So according to the previous response and according to the marker like enter follicle count, age and AMH, you should choose your protocol. Ideally, the antagonist protocol is used in these patients, but all patients may not respond to your particular protocol. So always start with a higher dose at the start of the stimulation. That may help in recruiting more follicle and may give a better response. Personally, I feel that priming with estrogen and using a delayed start antagonist protocol might help and give a better response in these patients. Always consider previous response whenever you are deciding the dose. That is another secret which you must practice. And finally, you must know the end and when to stop. So many times, in spite of using best protocol, considering everything, you may not get a good quality embryo in these patients. So have a option of egg donor program in these patients. I think if you consider, if you remember these five secrets for your poor responder patients, you might help them getting a better outcome in IVF protocol. I sincerely believe that these secrets which I have shared today will be of help to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Kuldeep, for giving such a nice discourse on poor response in IVF. In conclusion, I would just like to say that poor ovarian response in IVF is a very frustrating situation, both for the doctor as well as for the patient. And there is no magic protocol for poor responders. You can either use the agonist protocol. Actually, it is being the preferred protocol nowadays because of a good yield of eggs. And even a dual stimulation protocol can be utilized in IVF. The antagonist protocol can also be used in poor responders. Whereas, in addition, the autologous PRP intra-ovarian injection as well as the in vitro activation of oocytes or follicles await validation in more prospective RCTs before it can be recommended for poor response. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you like this video, please click on the like button and subscribe to our channel Global ART Forum so that we can get more such videos in the future. Thank you.